Alright. A couple days ago, I had put up a new combo for Cinder that I figured out was possible recently. And I haven't done any playing. All I've been doing is thinking while I was at work today. But there's a lot of processing and information and execution and everything that goes into, you know, maximizing ultra combos and stuff like that. Sometimes you discover tech randomly, like the thing that I discovered, which is Cinder's bombs. They actually do cool stuff, aside from just, you know, sticking to someone and, you know, throw and blow up, blah, blah, blah. So, I mean, while that's cool, you know, and they give you a safe way in sometimes, what I found out is, let's say you have three bombs on somebody, and then you do a one chance break here, and then you do an ender, they all explode and add ender level. So I got a level 2 instead of a level 1 from that. I'm pretty sure it would have only been a level 1 normally, but they add potential damage to your combos. Yeah, because see, that's normally a level 1. We'll see if I can do it with a shadow, why not? Yeah, it blew up. So, but yeah, he's still on fire. So I'll do a damage ender this time. We'll try that. Stop burning, Gargos. Well, I'll just adjust all my stuff here real quick. No blocks. Everything else is set. All right. But yeah, it's, hell, I'm sure you could probably even put two shadows on him. Yeah. It adds a ton of damage to stuff. So, that's what I found out. And the bombs exploding, they don't add any KB. The other things that I found out, the reason why part of it was possible is his new Inferno, you can hold it. And normally you want the most efficient way of getting KB, which, you know, is up, his jump canceled recaptures, which are kind of hard to do sometimes. So you have to get it pretty close to right when you come off the ground. I usually play against Gargos because he's a little bit easier to... His hitbox is a little bit higher. But I was also theorycrafting again, if it's possible to just do a punch right on the way up. Which it might be, we don't know. I don't think it is, but... No. It was worth a try. So what I did with the last one when I did that combo is I managed to get up to 108 hits before starting the second ultra off the wall splat, so the initial goal is to try and find a way to beat that. And the way I had it set up before, it was enough of these reset kicks to get to 19 on the KV meter, which let me do one full hold of Inferno, which is 45 KV, to to do the wall splat into an ultra and stuff. But I also was trying to find, I'm trying to find the most efficient way to get a level 2 ender, which is the only thing I'll be able to get off a recap without auto doubles. And auto doubles that build your ender level, but they're not efficient on the KV meter. So these were the thing that I found that was easiest to do it. So do something like that. But that's 19 KV for 5 hits. So if we do this for 5 hits, that's 17. So that's already more efficient. So let's try doing 6 hits. So if we go for 6 hits on that, it might work out. Might even try 7. We'll see what happens. But it's mostly just trying to find the most efficient way to do everything, because I want all three bombs to explode this time. See, that's one too soon, so I'll try it again. So I'll do, what was it, 7 hits? Yep. So we'll see what happens with this one now. Just make sure I don't mess it up. Looks like it still blew up on me. Or the one disappeared. So we're trying to get it to where the one doesn't disappear. So let's do 10 hits this time. I might not even be able to do an ultra off that. Oh, I can. Alright. So I might have to swap it to 20%. Just so I can actually land it. But yeah, all the timing and stuff for that. I mean, I know his Inferno can do a maximum of 13 hits. So you'll have to keep that in mind when you're doing these so that you know exactly how much meter you have to work with on your KV, because you have to let it go and cancel into shadow on your own. Yep. Almost had it. So I haven't even got into what you're supposed to do with the second KV bar, because those reset jump kicks are more efficient than doing manuals, but that puts the execution to a ridiculous cap. So if you're willing to do that... Does this go to level 2? Nope, that doesn't go to level 2, so 10 hits is too much. Let's try 8. Nope, you want 8. But yeah, see all this stuff, you gotta get the timing down for all of this. I want all 3 bombs if possible. That's what I want. I don't think it's possible to get all 8. But alright, we're going to round 2 here. I'll try and do reset kicks for this one. I want to try and do as many of those as possible, so I was hoping that something like this would work, where I can do that. Just jump punch. So I could always try it against Agonos too. Because sometimes these types of things, they work good against some characters and not against others. Cinder. Agonos. So, this is all part of testing your theories and trying out stuff. Let's go for 6 hits. I suppose I could see if the one thing works first. Because if it works against Agonos, that might be a little bit better for me. Yep, it does kind of work. So it does kind of work. Because the jump heavy punch is 4. So that's what I'm going to try to do after the instant cancel is that. Alright, as long as I can do that. So... But yeah, so you know, that's the type of stuff, like, that probably only works against Agonos, but because it works, and it's replicatable, somebody can try and beat my record using that tech. So that's something that I would consider, you know, acceptable. So we'll see what happens with this now. But I don't think the first KV meter can be improved at all. I'm thinking where it's at is exactly where it's gonna be at. That was just enough to get a level 2 ender. So. Oh, I should have just did a flip kick first. Alright. Yeah, see, now that's making the execution pretty hard. But I also need to figure out exactly how much time I have when I'm doing that. Because I have to land that, and then I want to do a charged inferno in there. And then cancel that into shadow, and then go into the third ultra. And then when the third ultra's done, I have to land. Oh, dang it, is he going to let me do it? Well, probably not, but I have to land that getting 10 hits into another one getting 10 hits. So I have to land two perfect shadow juggles at the very end. So if I mess up anything on the way there, I might beat my old record, but then that leaves room for improvement for another person to beat that. So when you do a combo, you want it to be as efficient as possible, and you want somebody to beating it to, you know, find something that you didn't find. So the flip kicks are more efficient than this here. So that's 20 kV instead of 19, but it's still more efficient than doing linkers and manuals, and it makes it a little bit easier to do buffers for it, but we'll see what happens. Well, that's not what I wanted to have happen. I think the flip kick buffer will be a lot easier against Agnos anyway. Dang it. It's so hard to time this though. Oh, man. Yeah, and then I'm trying to do that a bunch of times. I don't know, it just seems easier to start with the kick or the punch the one time. Oh. That's why I'm glad this is at the front, because that's not... That's like putting something hard early on is never good. There we go. And then I want to do that as many times as possible after my instant cancel, so I also have to do that. I wish I could talk and play at the same time, but some of this stuff is just so intricate that I have to be ready for it. Ah. Yeah. Yep, takes a while. This is what goes into these. So. Oh, that's the wrong one. Do it now. There we go. Alright. Jump kick. Yeah, you have not much time to do that. Like, the moment you see yourself leave the ground is when you have to do it. But, so now I'm trying to implement that after the instant cancel so that I can save myself some KV, and I'm hoping to land... Oh. I mean, if I land, like, 20 of them, which I know sounds ridiculous, but it's 3 to 4 KV apiece, which, without linkers, is amazing. But that also means that the skill cap for this combo goes way up. But you only need to land something like this one time. It's not something that you're going to sit there and hope to land in a real match. This is something that you sit in the lab and figure out. Good little string there too, though. But I mean, all this stuff is lab time too. Like, I've never seen anybody do the Cinder Pyro Bomb thing at all until this. Look at that. That racked up the hits like crazy. That's definitely tech for Cinder that I don't think anybody has used before. But it's either this video could end after this combo, or it could take me another 30 minutes to pull this off, because these flip kick resets, they're not easy. So you have to press jump, and then press down before you get off the ground, so that you can, you know, you have to press down so that you can do another kick. So your timing has to be pretty good on these. Yeah, it seems like I can get 5 in a row, but, I mean, I'll try for 5 on the next one, we'll see what happens. It's like jump resets. I'm sure it's the same thing for Sidira's combo in Season 1 when they had that. Oh, yeah, this is the live version of this. This is exactly what happens with these things sometimes. Sometimes you think you're doing everything just fine, and then you just drop the last one, or you miss it by like just a hair like that. Oh, I thought I had it. Come on. Why is this being so difficult? There we go. Man, yeah, these aren't easy. And all those videos that I have up of all the ones that I've done, it's like, I love a challenge, but some of these, they just get ridiculous. The amount of execution you have to pull off. So. Alright, let's hope I get it. I'm gonna try for 5 flip kicks. Hopefully it's enough. Story of my life. I would miss. Well, I know I can beat. I know that the combo is beatable, but I just don't know by how many hits. It really depends how many flip kicks you want to do. I mean, if you fill the whole KV bar with flip kicks, you'll beat the record, no problem. But the amount of the timing, the execution to pull that off, and then land the perfect juggle at the end, it's gonna take you a while. Or sometimes you have that happen. Pressing up down, I get a trailblazer for some reason. There we go. Alright. Yeah, this is the process that I go through for every ultra combo that I do. Some of them eventually are much easier than others, but someone like Cinder, his can be pretty damn hard. It all depends on just how much tech you want to throw into it. Alright. 5 flip kicks. We can do it this time. We got this. Surprising that works. Huh. Anyway. I don't know. So that's what I mean. You just try random stuff and you figure out weird things. Like, I didn't know that you could just do a continuous juggle right there with no trailblazers. You know, it's all heavy. Somebody's waiting for the recapture and it just doesn't happen. You know? But who knows? Man, it's already 20 minutes long. The other one I did was much easier. I kind of most likely got lucky doing it, because it's just like, you know, sight read, like, hey, this is an idea. Oh, hey, it worked. And then you just land the whole thing, and it's like, oh, that's cool. And now I'm actually, like, working at it, so I'm, like, focused on other things, which probably is hindering my execution. Plus, I'm talking. But we're just hoping. Like, I wish I could just get like a macro for this, just that part. All that felt like that was the right timing too. Sometimes it feels like it's super easy and you hit super high, and other times it feels like you get gimped out of it. But I mean, that's just a recap manual that it doesn't look like it should work. But it only works against high hitbox characters. Like Agnos, Gargos works. I'm sure Idol works. But it's usually why I just prefer to have Agnos as my opponent for ultra combos. Bigger hitbox makes the juggles easier. Higher hitbox makes stuff like Cinder's recap thing possible. I didn't press down fast enough. You have to, like, wait till you're off the ground. I don't know why it's so hard to do sometimes, but... I wish it was just that easy every time, right after instinct, too. Yep, it's a process. You learn a lot doing this, you learn execution, but see, I'm trying to execute things that, you know, they're not logical by any means. But I'm sure that recapture into spamming that, Inferno is unbreakable, so I mean, that's a good way to get some free damage, so that's also tech. So I guess at this point I feel like I've explained most things, and I just want to not have to record and do this, but I said I would do the whole thing live, so I'm going to do the whole thing live. There's probably going to be some quiet portions eventually, because I'm going to be focusing, but I'm trying not to worry about it too much. Let my mind go tunnel vision, my muscle memory take over, and then just let my mouth speak. It's the plan, anyway. Just hoping it doesn't go to too many parts. Oh, what? No Ender? Oh, that sucks. That's the first time I've done that. Now we're getting to the point where I'm just making stupid mistakes. I lost my place in the ultra combo for a second there. Oh, come on. I'm sorry for the announcer spamming, but man, I'm just not getting this down at all anymore. Okay, there we go. Yeah, that move does like 2 or 3 KV, so if you spam that for an entire KV meter, That's the most efficient way to get hits, but just the execution on it is ridiculous. So. I mean, it's up to anybody that wants to try, but, I mean, just landing everything perfectly is the hard part. I'm just gonna try for 2 flip kicks this time. Alright. I think we can do it this time. Oh, I pressed up. These are like one frame length, so at least they feel like it, at least buffering the up button to do the flip kick. I don't know, it feels easier to go backwards like that. But we'll see. I just hope this doesn't go to like an hour. Like, just this one needs to just do a little bit better. 2 flip kicks, no problem. Let's do it. Come on, 2 flip kicks. 2 flip kicks. Da 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 da. There we go. I dropped the manual. Dang it. Yep, so that's all the things that can happen. You gotta have the muscle memory, and you gotta be more than ready to fail at these quite a few times, especially if you're trying ridiculous stuff. That's the biggest thing with this, is like, it's high execution depending on what characters you pick. Like, someone like Jago, it's just heavy manuals, heavy linkers until the KV meter is full, and then a wall splat. Like, that's easy, but juggle characters, characters with different types of things they can do in combo, like that Inferno there, oh, I did the Ender, dang it. But, I mean, those types of characters are easy to land there. It's like, you figure out their simple juggle, which is 2 shadow fireballs and then a heavy laser sword, because it always hits twice, and then his ultra's done. But someone like Cinder, he can have probably tech for days. Get changed every couple hours, almost, if someone's willing to, you know, try for it. But, that was the same thing with, like, Gargos. Man, stuff was getting discovered for him, just every 20 minutes. I watched this combo go from like 210 all the way up to 268. It's ridiculous. But even Shadow Jago's, his was the same way. Characters that have awkward juggle traits or just random manuals or just different types of stuff, spacing, all comes into play. Alright, we got it this time. Dang it. Man. Hopefully it lands this time, because I just need to focus. Alright, focus. Probably not going to talk much more. I'm just going to focus on the combo. Didn't hold my Inferno long enough, had to throw a manual in there. You gotta be ready for that stuff too. Ah, I feel like that should have made it. I'm just losing my edge. There we go. Oh, dang it, I did do it right. I'm like, ah, I fucked up. I needed the ender. Ah, man. Mind melting. Just do it. Just do it. I'm just gonna stick with two flip kicks after the instinct, like, just putting this together takes far too long. Because I still have to land the shadow juggle at the end, too. We haven't even gotten there yet. So you get all the high execution stuff out of the way, and then you have that one just little thing at the end. Now I can't even do this anymore. I'm pressing jump. Man. I don't know how much trouble I'm having with this. I might as well just leave my record at 245. Oh my god. Why is this so hard now all of a sudden? I've done this how many times? Now my muscle memory is like betraying me. Oh my god. Sorry, Agonos, you just gotta kinda sit here and take this crap for a while. How did that one not combo? That felt like that should have comboed. I don't get why this isn't working. There we go. Well, I don't know why I'm having so much problems with this now all of a sudden, but, like, they're just not connecting. I really hope that I managed to beat that combo this video, otherwise, like, yeah. Alright. Well, even if I don't beat it, I'm still gonna upload this, but this is, like, I'm adding to it, like, the way it used to be, was, like, instant cancel straight into this. That's easy. Like, but instant canceling into two of these, that's hard, but it saves on KV, so it's something that you want to try and do, because it's what gets you the extra hits. It's how you break the records. You do the harder stuff. But it just seems like for whatever reason, like, I'm holding down, I jump cancel, and it just doesn't want to do it sometimes. And that was an up-down input, and it did a fire flash. So. I don't know, maybe I have to just tap up-down for whatever reason. It seems like that might work a little bit better. Let go of down. But those are all things that it's just hard to tell what's actually happening, because I don't know exactly how the game, you know, registers completely everything. I can only figure out what's been executing properly and what hasn't. Alright, but I think I got it this time. We'll see. Now it's just not working for me. That's why I usually try to put the hardest stuff at the beginning of the combo, but I do want to land two of those because it nets me one hit. But anything more than that just seems like it's too much, because like just the amount of executions just too high. And then there's always going to be that time where one person finally does it. And it's like, you know it's possible, but it's like, he took the time to just do it. And that's like, props to that person. Oh, alright. I'm going to give this a few more tries, because for whatever reason, landing them, I mean, that's something that's not meant to happen in this game, is comboing that. So that's what makes this hard. So you have to jump cancel the other one. But you can only tap up. Like, you can't hold up. Because if you hold up, it doesn't let you register a down input fast enough. You tap up and you gotta hold down, and then the moment you leave the ground is when you're pressing heavy kick. And yeah, it's not easy. Alright, give this a go. Just making sure. Because, yeah, that right there would have been two heavy manuals for 5 kV. So out of 100 kV, if you did that, your entire kV bar, that'd be an extra 50 hits. That's a huge amount of hits. That would definitely get you a record if you sat there and did that. But I don't want to sit there and do that. Like, I know how to do this, but sometimes it just doesn't want to work for some reason, and I don't get why. Like, I'm pressing the kick as soon as I feel like I have the frame to do it. Like, I'm up in the air, and then I press the kick button, and I'm holding down, but he just does a neutral jumping heavy kick and refuses to do the flip kick. That's why I'm limiting it to 2 after the instant cancel, because any more than that, and it's just like, you're gonna stress yourself out trying to pull off something, because I haven't even made it to the last juggle yet. Because if I don't land the perfect juggles, the one hit that I'm netting from doing those two flip kicks will be for nothing. There we go. Now we still have to land the perfect freaking shadow juggle, and I'm probably gonna... I'm hoping I get it. I'm hoping I do. Too early. Yeah. Way too early. But that difference of the flip kits nets me one hit. But I don't want to try again. I'll just do my favorite one and I'll explain it, because this one, it's easy to do, but it was hard, and it was like very, very hard to put it together and get it to finally work. But for Fulgore's, his record that I got was 141 hits, but the biggest and most, and like the, obviously his shadow meter generates on its own even while he's in combo. So you need max spin speed to do it, and you need to time it out so that when you're using shadow moves, you're gaining pips at the right time. And you'll see what I mean. So when I start my original, my first shadow move, I'm going to start it when my spin speed bar hits the fourth green pip. And you're going to do your slowest auto triples, which are heavy punch, and you're going to delay the last hit just a tiny little bit. And that'll give you the right pip spin speed generation to go for four shadows every time you do a new KV meter, and then three shadows worth of juggle. So, alright, I think I'm ready to go here. And you want to do slow shadows, like the eye laser. One heavy blade dash here, another eye laser, and then a just normal auto double into ender, and then into blade dash, and into ultra, and then after you instant cancel, you want to do a heavy manual into teleport, and look at that, you get a pip right away, delay your auto triple, three teleports because it's the slowest shadow he's got, and then in the time I do this, I should generate another shadow to go to the other side. Yep, there we go. And I left the KV at 90 because his ultra builds 8, and I need one hit available for my standing heavy kick. And then you cancel just like that. But I've done this one a bajillion times, so I know all the timing for it, and I don't drop this one. And then a medium projectile, and then mash ultra ender, because then you get 5. But that's the highest possible hit count that Fulgore can do in his current state, and I've done that one so many times. Like, I mean, I usually did it once a stage for my Ultra Ender series with him, but, I mean, like, you saw how much I was struggling with Fulgore's, and I did this one while talking. I mean, but then again, Fulgore's is deceptively easy to do. The hardest part about it is actually finding what location on your shadow meter gauge that you want to use shadows so that the pips line up exactly when you need them. I wish I could have pulled off the Cinder. I wish I could have. I'll try one more time against Gargos, because for whatever reason his seemed to be easier. If I don't land it this time, this video will still go up, but I just, like, this is what I do with these, is I'll sit here and I'll troubleshoot trial and error. Gotta expect to make mistakes, gotta expect to mess up, it's gonna happen. Like, these are not easy to do, especially if you're crunching the numbers on characters like Gargos, Cinder, you know, characters that have juggle potential, or characters that have recaptures, characters that have, like, things that can manual like this. Like, you know, manualing stuff like that, knowing exactly how much KV you need, I mean, you have to do a little bit of a combo, then start it, and then do that, and then figure it out from there. And it, that's the type of things that you gotta worry about. Something that you know the timing of, but it's just the game decides if you're gonna get it sometimes with stuff like this, because this isn't like a normal functioning combo. This is, you know, something that's not intended to happen for the most part, at least I don't think it is. But you're abusing it because it's the most efficient on the KV meter for you. Like, I don't understand. It's like I can get it 4 times in a row, and then every once in a while the one just misses for some reason, but... We're not gonna do the flip kicks, we're just gonna do the normal one off it, because I don't wanna sit here and waste too much time. No, we gotta do the flip kicks because we're trying to beat the record. Yeah. Of course we would drop it. No, not helping options. Restart. So, I have about 13 minutes left to record. I'll just go the full time. I'll try a few more times. See if we can get it. Yeah. Sometimes you think you'd make it, and then you don't. But... as far as, like, hard-to-perform stuff, this is probably, aside from Shadow Jago, like, the hardest one I've tried. Just because those flip kick, they're not easy to do. The timing is pretty strict. And then, like, if I was not doing them on the instant cancel, it wouldn't be so bad. I could go straight to the end of the Ultra every time, because the manuals aren't too hard. But it's just... it's just doing those at an inopportune time off a instinct reset. It's frustrating, but at the same time, it's like you gotta expect to fail. So now I don't understand why that one didn't recap and the other one did, but then again, I'm assuming it's based on how high I go. So, but that's all the parts of this that, you know. It's like none of those comboed. Not one. But. There we go. Yeah. This is also one of those times where I'd be, you know, the tech that I'm trying to pull off, like, it's unreliable, but it's doable. And I mean, it's been around since day one Cinder. Because that's what Vesper did in the original record that he posted before that was beaten. And then I didn't get my Ender. Ugh. Alright. So we need two of those after the instinct. And I already tried putting Pyro Bombs on them before you do the Ultra. Those don't explode. Man, it's the longest video I've recorded in a long time. What? Oh, I can't believe that didn't work. But... alright. This is like, gotta figure out the timing for these. It's strict. But you gotta do it. There we go. Starting to get more of a feel for the timing. But it's one of those, it's not a fundamental combo. That's something that's all like based on your input potential. If you can't input those, you'll never get them. Alright, just need two of them. And then finish the combo.
Oh, why did you auto-double Cinder? Cinder, why did you auto-double?
Oh, that was such a late auto-double, too. I think I missed it by, like, 2 frames, if that. I also have the sound really low, so I can't even hear half of this. So I'm just doing all this off visual right now, too. So that's a little bit awkward, but, you know, I want to make sure that people can hear me talking during this. I think I missed. Ooh, that was close. There we go. 189. Alright, now if we don't mess up this juggle and we land it perfectly, this will be 246. And we messed it up. Dang it. Ah well. It was a good try. I'm getting mentally drained doing this. That usually sometimes works, but we'll see. I'll keep trying for my little stylish combo here. Oh, I had it. Oh, you have to wait on that uppercut just so slow. One last try. We'll do it the normal way. Oh, no, you got a heavy kick there. Yeah. Just figuring out what normals juggle for what with Cinder is kind of tough sometimes.
Oh, no.
Yeah. He's high execution sometimes. No, he is high execution. There's no doubt about that. Oh, I could have did it, but anyway. Cinder's a lot of fun. He just takes so much work to get good with sometimes. You gotta know when and what to hit based off what height he's at. Anyway, thanks to everybody who stuck around and watched this whole thing. I know it kinda sucks that I didn't get the whole ultra combo in, but you know, sometimes you can't help it. Just happens sometimes. Anyway, we'll just finish off with this little bit here. Now watch, I'll just land everything just right here. Nope, alright, it failed, so we're okay with that. thanks for watching, and I hope it kind of sheds some light and helps you, you know, learn stuff. It's like sitting here doing ultra combos, it's actually good for you. So you learn stuff with your character that you might not think is possible. You know, like I never knew about the bombs with Cinder and, you know, cashing out or adding to your ender level and stuff. So that was a cool find. And I found that just completely by accident, just sitting here messing around with Cinder, trying to do this ultra combo stuff. So, alright, take care.